Long Boys by Steve Cleary. Faded. Exterior, suburban South Jersey lawn, morning. A pickup truck with an attached trailer loaded with landscaping gear pulls up to a modest, vinyl-sided house. Random landscapers unload equipment, string weed whackers, mix gas and oil, gas up lawnmowers, etc. They mow lawns, whack weeds, edge curbs, trim hedges, throw mulch, empty debris into truck beds, blow clippings, etc. The landscapers load the equipment back onto the truck and trailer and drive off, revealing a decently manicured lawn. Exterior, Mrs. Largent's house, backyard day. A puny landscaper, RIPPY, 18, works his way along a flower bed with his weed whacker and toward a birdbath standing upon a patch of crushed stone ground cover. Among the stones, a stubborn tuft of grass taunts him. RIPPY jabs his tool at the cluster. A barrage of pebbles spray toward the house. A window shatters. RIPPY winces.
Oh, balls.
Exterior, Mrs. Largent's house, down the street. A dump truck and pickup truck with attached trailer parked before a house. Both vehicles have faded door magnets. HEIKO's lawn care. Oafish, Brian, mid-20s, climbs onto the dump truck and empties a trash can full of grass clippings. His co-worker, short, thick, and hairy MUNGO, 23, blows clippings from the sidewalk onto the lawn with a blower. RIPPY walks up with his weed whacker and an armful of broken glass. He dumps the glass and straps his tool to the side of the truck.
Oh, way to go, stupid. For a minute there, I was worried you wouldn't do something boneheaded today.
Save your drama for your mom, Brian.
Brian jumps down from the truck and marches toward RIPPY.
Don't hit me! Hit him!
Huh?
He called you a slacker.
Brian glares at MUNGO.
What? Don't be such a wuss, dude. Lean into it. He ain't so big. He's just big boned.
Show your cornhole, MUNGO.
Brian scrutinizes MUNGO's work.
Just blow it out under the street, dummy.
Nah, dude. HEIKO says that's against the law in Margate.
You're against the law in Margate, stoner.
MUNGO continues blowing clippings onto the lawn. RIPPY strains to close the trailer gate. Brian climbs into the driver's side of the dump truck, empties his Gatorade down his throat, and lights a smoke.
Come on, a-holes. I need to stop at Wawa. Let's beat it before...
A screen door slams. MUNGO shuts the blower off.
HEIKO!
Brian looks out the passenger window.
I'm not here. Oh, great.
The senior lady, Mrs. Largent, storms toward the crew in a housecoat.
Where's HEIKO?
Hi, Mrs. Largent. He's not here today. He's sick.
Mrs. Largent gets in Brian's face.
Well, tell him he'll have to pay for that window, see?
Brian wipes a speck of Mrs. Largent's spittle from his cheek and gazes at the windshield.
Yes, ma'am. We'll see that, loud and clear.
She turns around. RIPPY gazes at his shoes.
Well, hello there, MUNGO. Tell your mother I said hi.
I will, Mrs. Largent. Sorry about that.
Mrs. Largent marches back toward her house.
Air conditioning torn off half the town. Social Security won't cover that.
Brian looks over to the passenger window. Cigarette smoke floats in the air on the other side.
She gone? Yeah, you can come out now.
The head and shoulders of a tan and wiry landscaper, HEIKO, late 30s, rises into view. He's handsome, but uptight.
What the hell, RIPPY? I told you to be careful around those rock gardens.
Oh, I thought they were tiny mushrooms.
We're behind today as it is. Screw it, I could be pumping gas in Sunoco or have a paper route.
Dude, take it easy. It's just a window.
Oh, just a window. I'm losing business because of you guys. Seriously, I'm going to drive the trucks into the bay and take over my niece's lemonade stand.
HEIKO checks his watch.
Great. My buddy's back in town and we're supposed to meet up. Man, if only I had a class act like him on our crew.
What's so classy about this guy? He heavy equipment certified?
No, better. He hangs out with rock bands and bangs strippers. And he wears these cool nerd glasses. He's really got his shit together.
He sounds like a real baller, HEIKO.
He has the sharpest balls I know.
Exterior, bike path, day. Steve, late 30s, a tall, schlubby guy, zips down a pleasant tree-lined bike path on an old three-speed. He wears Buddy Holly glasses, Chuck Taylors, and cargo pants cut just below the knee. He jams out to indie rock through his earbuds. He passes by housewives walking their dogs, rings his bell and waves hello. They ignore him. He rides along a section of rose garden. A big, douchey, white Ford F-350 blaring modern post-grunge rock speeds by. Grass clippings dump all over him.
Asswipe!
Steve flies screaming into a rose bush. Glasses fly off. He gags, spits out grass, and brushes himself off. Laughter bellows from the truck as it speeds away. A decal on the tailgate reads in a fiery tribal font, Summer's Eve Landscaping. Interior, marina restaurant, patio bar, day, locals only type of place next to a marina, tan and rugged fishermen types, waitresses with hard features. Classic rock plays off the jukebox over a Phillies game. Heiko and the boys sit at the bar. Paul, the bartender, 30s, delivers a green girly drink with an umbrella to Rippy.
Here you go, Rippy. Mountain Dew Shirley Temple.
Brian watches out of one of the monitors.
Yo, Howard's on third. Phillies, Phillies.
Brian looks around, expecting a big response from the bar, but gets nothing. Heiko looks over and sees Steve entering the bar, brushing clippings off himself.
Yo, Steve!
Steve looks over and walks towards Heiko. Brian sizes him up and looks at Mungo. Mungo shrugs. Rippy beams a bright smile. Brian resumes watching the game.
Hey, what's up there, Mr. Buttfister?
Steve and Heiko bro hug.
What are you doing back in town, butt clown?
I don't know. I got laid off, so I'm just gonna kick it around here for the summer.
Heiko picks up a clipping out of Steve's hair.
What happened to you?
The Mike Summers welcome wagon.
Oh, yeah. He still plays frog baseball behind the rec lodge. But Steve's a big city guy now.
What do you do up there, dude?
I work in advertising. Whiskey. Neat.
Anything we might have heard of?
Propecia.
Brian stays glued to the game and runs a hand over his receding hairline.
I heard of her. Propecia Johnson. WNBA All-Star.
Interior, marina restaurant, patio bar, night. Steve and Heiko's crew sit before several empty glasses and bottles. The bar is more crowded and the music is louder. A creepy, depressed man, JD, 50s, eyes them from across the bar. Steve doesn't notice. A sassy waitress, Lauren, late 20s, glides by Heiko and speaks into his ear.
Don't forget, I got off it too.
Heiko nods and the boys watch her walk away in envy.
I'm out of here. You know the chicks in here have crabs anyway.
Brian stumbles off. Heiko turns to Steve and puts a sloppy arm around him, sloshing Steve's drink. He doesn't mind.
So you're gonna stick around and help me put Summers out of business, or what?
Steve turns to him sloppily.
Me? Landscaping?
Come on, I'll pay you $15 an hour.
$15?
$15 couldn't even get me a coffee cart breakfast on Canal Street. I make 80 when I'm lowballing.
80? Dude, are you serious?
Wow, you must have some mad skills.
Steve's got mad seniority. He's been my number two since kindergarten.
Heiko casts pleading eyes to Steve.
I could really use the help.
Rippy and Mungo sulk. Steve sips his drink.
Sorry, guys. This mofo ain't leveling down for nobody.
Paul sets a credit card before Steve.
The cards decline, bro.
Steve turns to Heiko.
How about I start tomorrow?
Exterior, Ocean City 9th Street Bridge, day. The dump truck crosses over the bridge in light traffic toward the seaside community. Interior slash exterior, dump truck, day. Brian drives with Steve riding shotgun, looking pudgy in his high school gym shirt. Rippy is squeezed between them. Brian drums the steering wheel along to a Disturbed song. Steve stares at his smartphone. He looks out the window at JD pushing a lawnmower in a yard.
Who's that?
Oh, that's JD. He's weird. He works alone.
But he don't live alone. He keeps a gimp in the basement.
Rippy shudders. Steve returns to his phone. The song ends and a commercial for a local mortgage company comes on.
Atlantic Shore Mortgage for all your mortgage needs.
Stupid commercials. Change it.
Rippy tunes into an ad spot on another station.
Center City Sports for all your sporting good needs.
God, the ad copy sucks around here.
Rippy reaches once again and tunes to a new station. It's a commercial with futuristic background music.
Attention homeowners! Is the current drought drawing you out? Up to your neck in water bills?
Oh no, not these a-holes again.
Steve looks up from his phone. Rippy reaches to turn the dial, but Steve gestures for him to keep it on.
No, wait, what is this?
Natural gas is so last century. Get with the times with a new Cyberlon synthetic turf installation. Call in today for a free estimate. 609, it lasts!
The commercial ends with a jingle.
Cyberlon, your ticket to the 21st century.
Does HEIKO know about this?
Yeah, but who the hell would want a plastic lawn anyway?
Cyberlawn for all your synthetic lawn needs.
Ugh.
Exterior suburban street, job site. Brian backs a stand-on mower down the trailer. Rippy unstraps his weed whacker and Mungo starts up a zero-turn riding mower. Steve stares at his phone and his throwback Magnum PI nut huggers. HEIKO walks up to Steve with a weed whacker.
Hey! Hey!
Steve darts up and shoves his phone away.
Oh, sorry.
You okay with the weed whacker, butt crack attacker?
He checks the string and hands the tool to Steve.
Please. This ain't rocket science.
Cool, get these two hoses, then we'll go on to the next block.
Don't tell me what to do.
I'm the boss here, you. Just kidding. See you in a bit.
HEIKO walks back to the pickup. Steve leans over and yanks the pull cord to no avail. Rippy walks over.
You have to prime it first.
Rippy demonstrates on his own tool by pressing the primer bulb. He starts it up and sweeps away at the grass.
Oh, yeah, right. Forgot about that. Duh.
Steve presses the primer bulb a few times, then tries pull starting again. It doesn't start. He tries again and again, and it won't start. Rippy turns back toward him.
Give it some gas when you start it.
I know. Jeez, what's wrong with this thing?
Rippy walks away and starts trimming the edge of a sidewalk. HEIKO looks over from the truck, then hustles over to Steve.
This one's a little tricky. Let's get you on the self-propelled instead. I'll get this. The push mower.
HEIKO points towards the sidewalk. He starts the weed whacker right up and makes quick work of the edging. Steve pouts and walks over to the push mower on the sidewalk. He starts it on his first try and smiles. He pushes the running mower toward the lawn's edge.
Wait, dude!
Steve pushes hard and buzzes into the turf. He backs off the edge, revealing an unsightly crescent shape burnt in.
Yeah, real class act, HEIKO.
HEIKO drops his weed whacker and charges over to Steve.
Aw, man, you gotta set the wheel heights. You don't just plow into it. Ease up to it, like the thigh of your junior prom date.
I didn't go to junior prom.
Steve stammers. HEIKO leans down, snatches clippings off the ground, and tosses them onto the bare spot.
Forget it, I'll do it myself.
Steve fidgets. HEIKO lightens up.
Just go do Mr. Tucci's lawn over there. Butt hair, snare, care bear.
Exterior, Mr. Tucci's house. Front yard. Steve struggles to push a lawnmower along the long stretch of lawn. Large clumps of ground-up clippings lie in his wake. A late 90s model BMW pulls up. A stocky, middle-aged man, Mr. Tucci, 50s, hops out and marches toward Steve. Steve turns to see the customer and takes out his earbuds.
Where's your boss?
My boss? Oh, you mean HEIKO. I'm actually a friend of his, just helping him out for the summer, you know.
Steve smiles at him. Mr. Tucci glares at him.
I don't give a monkey's ass who you are.
Pardon?
Look at this mess. My special needs nephew could do a better job with his safety scissors.
Steve surveys the lawn and sees clumps all over the place, with tufts of grass missed by the mower. Mr. Tucci points at the lawnmower's clipping bag.
See this bag here?
Yeah.
See this trash can?
Yes.
Put the contents of this bag into the trash can. Do it often, capiche?
You got it.
The man marches off. Steve takes off the mower bag.
Monkey's ass in the trash can. Capiche?
Exterior, Mrs. Gunther's house. Backyard. Steve pushes his mower along a flower bed and mows over a patch of vegetable garden. Cut leaves spray into the lawn. Mrs. Gunther, 70s, rides up to him on a scooter. Steve notices, rolls his eyes, and takes out his earbuds.
My babies, look what you've done to my tomato plants.
Oh, sorry. I thought they were weeds. You see, I'm not really a landscaper. I work in advertising.
Mrs. Gunther stares back at him.
Leave my precious babies alone.
Yes, ma'am.
Exterior, Dr. Slattery's house. Backyard. Steve pushes the lawnmower along a flower bed, keeping a safe distance. He gets past the flower bed and smiles. He approaches the edge of the swimming pool and clippings fly into the water. Steve turns to see a pudgy academic type, Dr. Slattery, 60s, scowling at him with arms folded.
What in the world is the matter with you?
No comprende, señor?
Exterior, marina restaurant, patio bar, night. Steve and Iko's crew sit at the bar. Steve sulks before a Manhattan, staring at his iPhone. His arms are lobster red.
Nice drink. What are you, 70?
That maraschino cherry matches your arms, Steven.
Hey, cheer up. It was only your first day.
Steve remains looking at his phone, then sets it on the bar.
Yeah, well, not a single bite on my resume. Can this day get any worse?
It smells like semen over here.
The crew turns towards the entrance, and a burly group of roided-out men, the Summer's Eve landscaping crew, walk their way. Fanboys of Under Armour and Axe body spray. Mike, late 30s, leads the pack and approaches them, his tribal armbands on display and his muscle shirt and his billowing locks qualify him to model for romance novels.
Which one of you farted?
His crew bursts into laughter.
I don't know. I smell poop. Which one of you burped?
Mike's crew growls. He fumes and closes in on Rippy.
What?
Steve raises a hand between Mike and Rippy.
Hey, now, Mike.
They catch eyes for the first time in 20 years.
Ass wipe? I thought that was the other day. Where you been? Skipping through meadows with your life coach?
I live in Manhattan.
Mike shoves Steve back into the bar and keeps walking.
Thanks for the new customers, Heiko. You're making me more dough now than when you worked for me.
The rival crew guffaws. A more Weasley crewman, Joe, early 30s, with tribal arm sleeves and pencil beard, slants his eyes with his fingers.
Yeah, domo arigato, Heiko.
The crew laughs again. Another dopey crewman, Bill, 20s, tribal neck sleeve, follows up.
What kind of a stupid name is Heiko, anyway? Ching tang chao.
It's German, you idiots.
Mike raises a fist to Mungo, who bumps it with his own.
Hey, Mungo, say hi to your mother for me. What's up, Brian? Still working with these bowl scrapers?
The crew moves on and finds seats at the other side of the bar. Mike half-hugs Lauren, a little too familiar with her. Brian pouts. He slaps money on the bar and slips away. Heiko drinks his beer silently. Steve stews at the bar.
Mike Summers. What a jerk. What a bag of whatever would compel someone to call their business Summer's Eve.
I think it's poetic.
Yeah, isn't that the Shakespeare sonnet or something?
Google it, Heiko. How is it even possible for someone to remain so... Heiko?
Steve turns and sees Heiko exiting the bar.
Oh man, I'm blowing it.
Don't worry about it, dude. You'll get the hang of it.
I belong to the city.
Well, you're here now. Just a dab. Like my life coach says, bloom where you're planted.
Yeah, man.
You have a life coach?
Yeah, dude. You mean you don't?
Not really.
You got your back, dude.
He pats Steve on his sunburned shoulder. Steve shrieks. Exterior, Suburban Street, day. The crew unload gear off the trucks. Steve backs a lawnmower down the trailer gate. Heiko approaches Steve and lights a cigarette.
Hold on.
What's up?
We need some supplies. Would you mind taking the truck over to Ronnie's to pick up a few things?
Okay.
Heiko takes a note out of his pocket and hands it to Steve.
Cool. I wrote it all down. Just tell them to put it on my account.
All right.
Steve hops into the pickup truck. He closes the door, starts it up, and looks to Heiko.
Hey, look. So sorry again for screwing up yesterday.
Dude, forget it. Just hurry back.
Heiko turns away and Steve puts the truck in gear. Steve jolts out of the spot. The trailer gate slams down, and all the gear flies onto the street. Sparks fly as the trailer gate drags along. Exterior, Ryan's Garden Center, day. Steve pushes along a flat bed cart and peruses his list. A lean, mild-mannered, and balding clerk, Carl, 50s, approaches Steve.
Can I help you find something?
Yeah, do you have any arborvitaes?
Arborvitaes?
Yeah, arborvitaes. Have any of those?
Yep, over here.
The clerk walks Steve over to a collection of shrubs.
So we have little gems, hetz midgets, pyramidales, Ryan gold.
Steve leans over a juniper bush and feels a branch.
That's a juniper.
Oh, you know, just the standard, basic, you know, fully functional variety. Three of them, please.
Carl pulls a shrub out.
Let's go with the emerald green.
Carl helps Steve load them onto the cart.
What else you need?
Steve studies the list again.
Yeah, hydrangeas? Yes, hydrangeas. Sorry, I'm having a little trouble with my friend's chicken scratch.
Yep, over here.
The clerk walks Steve over to the hydrangeas.
Okay, so we got Red Beauty, White Spirit, Hot Red, Early Blue Rosa.
Steve is overwhelmed by the variety of colors. An earthy Stevie Nicks type clerk, Sunny, early 30s, walks up to her workmate.
Hey, Carl. Sorry, we need some help with the cash register. The tape's stuck again.
Ah, piece of crap. Came with the Haitian garden gnomes.
Carl walks away. Steve looks from the flowers to his list and back again.
This list doesn't say what kind.
So what you thinking?
I don't know. Compositionally, I think this would juxtapose well with the arborvitae.
He turns to her and is struck by her general nature.
Sorry, art speak.
Oh, like the speciality of that one really evokes a contrasting dialectic?
Steve looks into her eyes. There's something about this Jersey girl. She smiles back at him.
Yeah, that really resonates.
Steve's phone vibrates. He looks at it and sighs.
I'll just go ahead and take these.
Steve points at a few light blue potted hydrangeas.
Good eye.
Steve loads the plants onto the cart.
Thanks for your help. Bye.
Steve lunges the cart forward, hops onto it, and plows into a row of ficus trees. Exterior, suburban backyard. Day. Steve and Mungo stand before a zero-turn riding mower in the backyard.
You sure this is a good idea?
Yeah, dude. Look at all the space back here. Just take your time, you'll get the hang of it. Watch.
Mungo jumps onto the riding mower seat and starts it up. The mower roars.
This lever lowers the blade.
Mungo pushes a lever and the blade engages. He pushes lap bars with each hand and circles around Steve.
Now push this one to go to the right and this one to go left. Push them at the same time to go straight.
See? Yeah. Yeah, that seems pretty straightforward.
Mungo stops the mower and hops off.
Okay, now you try.
Steve clambers onto the seat. He pushes the lap bars and jerks forward.
Easy, breathe.
Steve straightens out and wobbles forward.
If you're getting it.
Yeah, this ain't no fang.
Good, just keep going around back here while I finish the front. I'll be back in a little bit.
Steve works the lap bars and wobbles down a swath. He reaches the end of the property and turns around.
I got this.
He comes back down the other way and pushes the levers further and goes faster.
Tokyo Drift!
He reaches the other end of the property and pulls the lap bar back to turn, but it's stuck. He barrels through a vinyl fence and into the next yard.
Oh shit! Mungo!
Steve struggles at the controls. A yapping dog barks at him, right in his path.
No! No! Look out!
Steve veers hard and squints. The mower buzzes over a pile of pine cones. He crashes through the bush, twigs and branches stabbing him. He charges into the woods. Exterior, woods, continuous. Steve careens through the woods, yanking the lap bars and dodging the oncoming trees and low-hanging branches. He approaches a clearing and, though still at full speed, he sighs. He's out of the woods. Exterior, field, continuous. A little white object hits the riding mower with a clang.
What the?
Another clang, and then another clang clang. One pelts him in the thigh.
Ow! Asswood!
Steve looks up to see he's on a driving range. Mike Summers and his crew guffaw at their tees, swinging their clubs. A slew of golf balls rain down on Steve. He cowers as balls pelt the mower, his shoulder, and legs.
Ah!
Steve looks up. He's racing toward a driving range netting. He jams and pulls the levers, jerking left and right. Steve covers his face with his arms, and the mower slams into the net. The mower abruptly stops up the slope of the net. He's safe for now, but the wheels and blades still spin.
Oh, thank God!
Steve catches his breath and is about to hop off.
S-wipe!
Another barrage of golf balls fly at him. Steve covers his head with his arms.
Would you stop that?
The mower blades cut into the net and he lunges forward onto a fairway.
Ah!
Exterior, fairway, continuous. Steve zips screaming onto the fairway, heading directly toward a water hazard. The mower drops in off the edge, sending Steve flying headfirst into the water. A crowd of golfers gather by. Steve emerges covered in lily pads. Without his glasses, he gags out a lungful of dirty water. a senior country club member calls down to him.
Are you a member here, sir?
Exterior country club, later. HEIKO storms out of the entrance. Steve follows, drenched by his dip in the water hazard. He struggles to keep up with HEIKO without his glasses. Entering middle-aged golfers step out of their way.
You had no business riding that mower. I'm gonna kill Mongo.
It wasn't his fault. I'm telling you, the controls weren't working. I could have been killed.
I'm losing customers left and right. Brian just quit. And now our prized possession is at the bottom of a water hazard.
Tell me, Potters. They were designer frames, man.
The zero turn, idiot. If it weren't for Mongo's mom, you'd have hell to pay. No more riding mowers for you.
Fine with me. This landscaping bullshit is beneath me anyway.
HEIKO stops dead in his tracks.
What did you just say?
You heard me. Landscaping is for uneducated, uncultured suckers.
Oh yeah? Well, check this out.
HEIKO lifts up his shirt to reveal a perfectly toned and tan six-pack.
How many people our age have a hard body like this?
Steve leans in for a closer look.
Huh. Yeah, that's right. And I haven't stepped foot in the gym since Cub Scouts.
They are pretty ripped.
Excuse me.
HEIKO and Steve turn to see two fit and spray-tanned women, Connie and Linda, late 40s, approach them in tennis gear. Steve squints to get a good look at them as Connie eyes Aiko's midsection.
Did we hear you say you were landscapers?
HEIKO drops his shirt.
That's right, and damn proud of it.
Yeah,
me too.
HEIKO glares at Steve.
Did you hear that, Linda? We have a couple of professionals here. Maybe they can come over to the condo and trim the bushes.
But Connie, we don't have bushes.
Steve and HEIKO drop their jaws.
Well, they don't know that, silly.
Oh, right.
The boys exchange smarmy looks.
So what do you say? Would you mind coming over and getting a little dirty?
HEIKO puts an arm over each of the ladies' shoulders and leads them off.
Yeah, let's go. He's on suspension.
What?
Exterior, Dr. Slattery's house. Street, day. Steve, now glasses-less, sulks on his three-speed. He rides by Dr. Slattery's house and sees a summer's eve truck parked out front. Brian cruises up on his stand wearing a summer's eve shirt and flips Steve the bird. Steve continues pedaling along, then picks up the pace. Exterior strip mall, street, day. Steve zips down the street in high-intensity cardio mode. The endorphins are kicking in, but his pant leg catches in the bike chain and he skids to a stop. He struggles to free his pant leg and looks up. A banner above a Chinese restaurant catches his eye. Magnificent Palace Chinese Restaurant, now under new management. Steve smiles, hops back on his bike and zips off. Interior, Steve's bedroom, night. Steve sits at a desk before his laptop. He holds his phone to his ear.
So, we cool then? Oh, good. How'd it go with the Golden Girls, by the way? So, they literally put you to work burning a viburnum? Huh. Anyway, you're gonna love what I'm working on. Trust me, I may not be the best landscaper, but I know a thing or two about marketing. Cool. Thanks. Butt spanks.
Steve sets the phone down and looks at the monitor. A graphic design application is active on the screen. He mouses up to the menu and selects Create New Project. Exterior, lawn, day. Steve finishes the lawn with his mower and waves to HEIKO. HEIKO looks at Steve's wobbly one-direction circular lawn pattern and shakes his head. He points to the next lawn. MUNGO finishes up a beautiful striped pattern. Exterior, lawn, day. RIPPY demonstrates starting a weed whacker for Steve. Steve tries and the pull cord snaps. Exterior, driveway, day. HEIKO and Steve stand before a huge mound of mulch on the truck bed. HEIKO hands Steve a shovel and points to the mound. Exterior, backyard pool, day. MUNGO rides his mower by two tanning girls, 20s, by a pool in a backyard. He tips his hat. They ignore him. Exterior, driveway, day. Steve struggles with shoveling mulch into a wheelbarrow, climbs down from the truck, then struggles to push it. HEIKO runs up and steals it away. Exterior, lawn, day. MUNGO walks backward, edging a sidewalk with an edger. RIPPY approaches from the opposite direction, doing the same with a weed whacker. They collide. Interior, Steve's bedroom, night. Steve sits at his desk working on a website, focusing on a sign up now button. Exterior, lawn, day. Steve finishes his lawn, this time with a well-done cross-hatch pattern. HEIKO shakes his head again and gestures to the next lawn. MUNGO finishes up a beautiful bullseye pattern. Exterior, lawn, day. RIPPY demonstrates a proper weed-whacking sweep, then hands the tool to Steve. Steve kicks up a cloud of dirt with the tool. They look over and see MUNGO with dirt sprayed all over his face and chest. Exterior, yard, day. RIPPY trims a bush with pruning loppers. He clips the wrong branch and it leaves a big hole in the plant. He looks around, jams the branch back in, and scurries off to the next bush. Exterior, driveway, day. Steve shovels a little faster, climbs down a little more gracefully, and pushes the wheelbarrow a little more stably. HEIKO runs up and darts away with it again. Exterior, backyard, pool, day. MUNGO passes by the tanning girls from the other direction with a leaf blower and sneakily blows clippings onto them. The girls shriek out. Interior, newspaper office, day. Steve and HEIKO shake hands with an account executive, 30s. Exterior, lawn, day. Steve finishes his lawn again, this time with yin-yang symbol. HEIKO nods. Not bad. Steve makes the namaste gesture to HEIKO. HEIKO gestures over to MUNGO's lawn, an elaborate crop circle with complex geometry. RIPPY flashes the live long and prosper gesture. Exterior, driveway, day. Steve shovels the last bit of mulch into the wheelbarrow, pauses to catch his breath and wipes sweat off his brow. HEIKO runs up, but Steve quickly jumps off the trailer and dashes off with the wheelbarrow a second before HEIKO. Interior, salon, day. Steve sits in a barber chair, with his hair being styled by Linda. He spins around in the chair, revealing a new, clean, close-cropped hairdo. MUNGO spins around, his hair and beard trimmed neatly. RIPPY spins around, revealing a vintage Justin Bieber cut. Exterior, driveway, day. HEIKO peels off the old magnetic door sign and slaps on a fresh new, brightly colored one. Yard bodies lawn care. Exterior, driveway, day. The guys hang around the truck eating subs. Steve arrives in a new t-shirt with a ta-da pose to their applause. He tosses each guy a new shirt from a box. HEIKO does the tricep flex in his new tank top and lifts up his shirt to show his abs. MUNGO does the Hulk Hogan double bicep flex in his new muscle shirt. RIPPY poses in his new tank top, flexing his biceps and alternates kissing them. Exterior, driveway, day. HEIKO talks on his cell phone, ends the conversation, switches it off and puts it in his pocket. He gives the crew a big smile and thumbs up when he feels it ringing again. Picks it up and starts talking again. Exterior, walkway, day. Steve blows clippings off a walkway when a sexy woman appears in the front door with a tall glass of lemonade and makes a come hither finger gesture. Steve looks around and back at her. She nods and Steve drops the blower and goes with her into the house. Exterior, backyard, day. MUNGO rakes up leaves and screen door slides open. A sexy housewife appears with a come hither gesture and a glass of iced tea. MUNGO drops the rake and follows her inside. Exterior, house, day. RIPPY blows clippings on the sidewalk. A heavy set woman steps out the front door with a hot dog overloaded with all the fixings and does the come hither gesture. RIPPY freezes. HEIKO, with his own trimmers, laughs at RIPPY from the next yard when a woman's hand yanks him off screen by the shirt. Interior, gym locker room, day. Joe and Bill snap towels at each other. Mike sits in a towel, scowling at a newspaper. He balls it up, punches a big dent into the locker, and storms off. Bill and Joe look at the newspaper to see HEIKO's new ad. Yard Bodies Lawn Care. You'll love our body of work. Exterior, Ronnie's Garden Center, day. Steve, whistling, pushes a flatbed cart along an aisle of various potted plants. He picks one up, studies it, sets it down, picks up another and sets it on the cart. He swaggers along, tan, healthy, and knowing what he's doing. Passing female customers check him out. He pretends not to notice. Sunny does, however. She approaches Steve, pushing a large cart of plants.
Hello.
Yeah. Hey, are those the Achilles rhododendrons?
They are. Wow, you've got quite the green thumb.
Thanks. It's been getting a lot of action lately.
Steve takes one from her cart and sets it on his own.
What's your name again?
Sunny.
Steve wipes his hand off and shakes hers.
Steve.
You work for HEIKO, right? I heard about what happened at the golf course.
Steve stammers and spots a poster on the wall.
What's this?
Oh, it's that landscaping rodeo thing.
Steve takes a closer look. Insert poster. 5th Annual Home Depot South Jersey Regional Landscaping Combine. Seaview Country Club, July 11th. Steve studies the details.
Summer's Eve wins every year. We're sponsors.
Interesting.
Steve turns back to Sunny.
Yeah, Heiko's a good friend of mine. I'm just helping out till I get back to New York.
Ah, big city guy, huh?
You could say that. I prefer to be around a lot of culture, you know?
Uh-huh.
They pause and lock eyes like they did weeks before. This time, Sunny breaks the gaze.
Well, I better get these where they need to go.
She starts to push the cart off. Steve watches her go away.
Hey, Sunny.
She turns around.
Would you like to go out for a hot dog or a Slurpee or something?
You want to take me on a date to 7-Eleven?
Sure, if that's what you're into.
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
I don't have a lot of free time these days.
No worries.
I've got a kid and all.
Got it.
And I don't date grassholes.
Yep. Wait, did you just call me a grasshole?
I'm sorry, I meant landscapers. My ex is one, and I prefer to stay clear of them, being in the industry and all, you know?
Well, technically, I'm not a landscaper, but whatever. I see what you mean. See you around.
Steve turns and pushes his cart away. He whistles the Who's behind Blue Eyes.
Wait.
Steve turns around.
Do you like 80s music?
You mean like top 40s, 80s, or new wave? I'm more into Britpop myself.
That's 90s.
Oh, right.
Well, there's this thing at the elementary school. Not sure if there will be any new wave, but I guess it will give you a taste of the local culture, if you're interested.
Sunny fidgets. Steve relaxes his shoulders.
Like, don't gag me with a spoon. Sounds totally rad.
Interior slash exterior, pickup truck, day. Steve drives along listening to a Wham song on the radio. He looks over to see a Cyberlon truck parked in front of Dr. Slattery's house. Workers lay down a section of artificial turf. In the corner, JD pees on an installed section and gives Steve a thumbs up. Steve furrows his brow and drives on. Interior Mexican restaurant, day. Steve and the boys look at the menus. HEIKO talks on the phone.
Okay, Mrs. Pittman, we have you on the schedule for Wednesday. Yeah, if it's hot enough, we'll work with our shirts on. No extra charge. Okay, thanks. Bye-bye.
HEIKO puts his phone down and writes into a notepad.
All right, make it quick, kids. At the rate we're going, we're going to need to hire some more help.
I'm getting chicken fajitas.
Rippy, please. Fajitas are not Mexican food. Look at everything up here. Cabeza, sesos, lenguas.
I don't touch anything from tongue to bung, dude. I'm getting a cheeseburger.
A cheeseburger? You rubes are in serious need of some cultural immersion.
Rippy and Mungo exchange a furtive glance. Mungo returns to his menu.
Wow, you're so worldly, dude. But did you ever have nopalitos?
Rippy snickers. HEIKO leers up from his notepad.
Seriously? I love me some nopalitos. I've been to every taqueria in New York and the Mission District, but you guys wouldn't know anything about that.
A mousy Mexican waitress, 30s, appears with her order pad. Steve smiles to her.
I'll have a plate of your yummy nopalitos, señorita.
The waitress looks to the others cautiously. They crack up.
You sure, man?
Of course. In fact, make it a suprema.
Okay, señor.
Exterior, Mrs. Russo's house. Backyard, day. Steve pushes a mower along while blissfully listening to music through his earbuds. His stomach gurgles. He stops and winces.
No, no.
Steve lets the mower shut off, looks around, and spots a garden hose. He waddles toward it with full butt clench.
Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no.
He turns the spigot on, removes his shorts, and tosses them aside. He pulls the waistband of his boxers forward and glances down. He'd sharted. He flails the garden hose.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Steve sprays the hose down his underwear, then takes them off. He douses his backside and throws the boxers over a rose bush.
Okay. It's okay. It's over.
Steve turns off the water. He stands there, bottomless, catching his breath. He looks over and sees Mrs. Rizzo, 50s, peering out at his manhood just above her sunglasses.
Well, now.
Steve scrambles, picks up his shorts, and covers himself.
Hi, Mrs. Rizzo. Just hosing off some mud.
She steps toward him.
How about I dry you off?
Steve darts to the mower, keeping covered by the shorts. He backs away to the gate. He puts his shorts on backwards.
That's okay, Mrs. Rizzo. I'll come finish this later, okay?
Steve holds up his shorts and hastily pulls the mower through the gate. His underwear remains on the rosebush. Exterior, Deborah Gullickson's house. Backyard, day. Steve, on his hands and knees, spreads mulch under a row of shrubs against the house and hums along to music on his earbuds. A wheelbarrow a quarter full of mulch next to him. A little boy, Tyler, 7, walks up from around the corner and grabs at the wheelbarrow. The contents shift and the wheelbarrow teeters, about to fall on him. Steve turns around and quickly steadies the wheelbarrow.
Hey, don't do that. You're gonna get yourself hurt there, Tiger.
You're not the boss of me.
Steve is taken aback. He rips out his earbuds.
What? No. Wait a minute, kid.
Underwear head?
Underwear head? You're the underwear head.
Booger face?
Okay. Oh yeah, booger eater.
You're a bird.
You're a fart.
You're a darn it.
You're a damn it.
The boy pauses and lets out a wail.
Wait. I was just kidding.
The little boy disappears around the corner of the house.
Mommy!
Steve stands frozen and scared. A moment later, the little boy returns with his mother, Deborah, mid-30s.
Did you just call my son a damn it?
Yeah, but he started it. He called me an underwear head.
What kind of sick man are you?
I'm not sick. Look, he almost knocked over. Wait, Debbie Kraminsky.
It's Deborah Gullickson now.
It's me, Steve Connolly. I was in home ec with you. We made macrame beer cozies together.
Yeah, I know who you are. Look, just stay away from my children, okay? Come on, Tyler.
The mother takes her child by the hand and storms off. The boy turns around and sticks his tongue out at Steve.
No thanks. I use toilet paper.
Interior / exterior, pickup truck, day. Steve flies through the streets in the pickup.
I know who you are. It's Debbie Gullickson now. Stay away from my little punk-ass kids.
Exterior, cemetery, day. HEIKO, MUNGO, and RIPPY each operate weed whackers around the headstones. They turn to see Steve's truck approaching. Steve parks next to the dump truck. He hops out, slams the door, and grabs a weed whacker out of the back. He yanks it started and marches into the graveyard, thrashing through the weeds efficiently despite his rage.
Kind of sick man are you? I know who you are.
Deborah Gullickson, yeah.
HEIKO and MUNGO lower their tools and turn to each other. Impressed. Steve picks up the pace and makes quick work of several headstones. RIPPY hops out of the way.
Look, I don't have a lot of free time these days.
I got a kid.
I don't date rattles.
Steve guns his weed whacker at full throttle and wildly swings it at the weeds. He cuts through several more headstones and the weed whacker sputters to a stall, out of gas. He drops the tool and catches his breath. HEIKO approaches him.
Hey, what's the matter, diarrhea splatter?
RIPPY and MUNGO snicker. Steve glares at HEIKO.
Would you stop with those stupid butt rhymes? Oh, and real clever with the nopalitos, wise guys.
RIPPY and MUNGO calm down and stay at bay.
Aw, come on, so you sprayed a little chocolate in your drawers. You knew what you were getting into.
Steve catches another breath and composes himself.
It's not it. I mean, I had a fantastic life in the city. Swanky parties, yellow cabs, dates with Lane Bryant models.
Oh, here we go again.
Yeah, well, now I'm just a lawn boy to people that barely spoke to me in high school.
So what? Screw them, look at us. We're out in the sun, getting tan, getting fit. Well, they're locked indoors, fat, sickly, and slaves to their time clocks and snot-nosed kids. You don't want that, do you?
Steve calms down.
Yeah, but...
You know you don't. Hell, you haven't even looked at your phone for weeks.
Steve checks his pocket for his phone.
Sure, go back to a cushy desk job if you want, but check this out. Come on now.
Steve looks down at his own belly and sees some abdominal definition. Rippy and Mungo walk over him.
Hmm. You really want to keep this up? People like that envy us, believe me. It's like they say, men want to be us, and women want to be on us.
Steve reflects for a moment and gets pumped.
You know what? You're right.
Yeah!
Yeah.
We own this town.
Damn right.
Yeah!
Men want to be with us, and women want to be by us.
Something
yeah.
like that.
Yeah!
The crew all gather, hooting and hollering, yeah, yeah, high-fiving, beating their chests, etc.
Now, don't you have a date with that cute little garden center chick?
Sunny? No, that's not really a date.
So what? At least she's interested.
Yeah, just give her a chance to let you grow on her, dude.
Yeah, then you can grow in her.
Rippy does a provocative hip throws.
Rippy, guys, she's a respectable young woman with a brilliant mind.
Trust me, if a chick is a kid and invites you to meet him on a first time out, she's gotta be into you.
Yeah? Yeah. Well, I guess I'd better jet.
Steve turns and runs off.
Now go tap that brilliant, respectable, plant-potting intellect.
Exterior, Mill Road Elementary School, dusk. A sign out front reads, Mill Road Elementary School Chorus presents 80s Music Review, tonight. Interior, Mill Road Elementary School, auditorium, night. A group of kids, 8 to 10, stand on stage singing Taylor Dane's Prove Your Love or some such substandard. Their music teacher, Mrs. Wolf, 40s, accompanies them on piano, lost in the rapture in her shoulder-padded blazer. Among a sea of proud parents, 30s to 40s, in folding chairs, Steve sits next to Sonny and fans himself with a program. Sonny looks to Steve. He ekes out a smile. Interior, Mill Road Elementary School, lobby, later. Steve and Sonny stand among a crowd of parents congratulating their kids, etc.
So what did you think?
Interesting selection of the decade's B-sides.
Yeah, Mrs. Wolf thought it would get the parents more involved. They went through all the standards 2 programs ago.
Mm.
Several mothers, 30s to 40s, catch eyes with Steve through the crowd. Sonny pretends not to notice. Steve smiles back. The more blue-collar husbands, 40s, scowl at him and pull their wives closer. Steve tones it down. A young boy, Kyle, 8, approaches them.
There he is, my sweet little brooding rock star!
She leans down to hug and kiss him on the cheek.
Mom! Kyle, this is my friend Steve.
Kyle looks up to Steve. They shake hands.
What's up?
Great job on the heartbeat. You really out-Don Johnson Don Johnson on that key change.
Who the crap is Don Johnson?
Steve looks behind Kyle and sees the little boy Tyler from earlier. Above him, Deborah talks with a couple, 30s, while her daughter Maddie, 10, looks bored. Steve's eyes widen. Tyler notices Steve and tugs at his mom's arm to get her attention. Steve turns back to Kyle.
How about some ice cream?
Yeah, can my cousins come?
Sure, little man. Who are your cousins?
Deborah walks up to them, her kids in tow. She casts a stink eye at Steve while pecking Sonny on the cheek.
Hey, sis.
Exterior, Lucy the Elephant, night. A tourist attraction of a building shaped like an elephant. Kyle chases around the legs of the giant plaster pachyderm with other children, 7 to 11, wielding ice cream cones. Steve and Sonny watch from a bench, each with their own cones. Deborah scowls at them from a distance while watching over Tyler. Maddie stares blankly toward him as well.
Wow, I can't believe you're Debbie Kerminsky's little sister.
Better get your believer fixed.
I don't think she likes me.
She doesn't like anybody. Check out that rusty bitch face. It ain't hiding anything.
Steve takes in Deborah's unfriendly default expression. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree with Maddie.
But she's been a great help for us.
Where's her husband?
You kidding? Everyone's divorced around here, you know that.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on. Divorced cougars and MILFs are your target market.
Well, yeah, some of our new customers fit that demographic.
Uh-huh. I see you guys parading around in your camel muscle shirts. Heiko's with a different woman every time I see him. I even saw Rippy buying Trojans at the dollar store.
I hadn't noticed.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just doing my part to keep a friend's business viable.
Uh-huh.
It's not about the women, I swear.
Sonny studies him. Steve studies her back, then shoves the remainder of his cone in his mouth. Exterior, Sonny's house, street, night. Steve pulls up in a white minivan. Kyle hops out of the sliding door and runs up to the house. Sonny watches him from the passenger seat.
Nice minivan. You sure you've never had kids?
No, but my mom has. I'm a city guy, remember?
Right. When are you going back?
To New York? I don't know. I'm thinking I'll have enough saved up by Labor Day.
That's a sound objective.
And I don't want to miss the altar wine jello shots at the church barbecue, of course.
Of course. Well, I'd better catch up with Kyle before he boots up Minecraft. Last time we stayed up till 7 a.m. Thanks for the ice cream.
Sonny opens the door.
Hey, we can be friends in the meantime, right? You can teach me about gardening and then come visit when I'm back in New York. We don't need to be kissy or penetrate-y or anything.
Sonny's taken aback, then breaks a smile.
Knucklehead!
Come on. What do you say, chum? About it, pal.
Sonny takes a beat. He is rather charming.
Okay, sure.
Steve raises his hand up.
High five?
Interior, gym, day. Full-on meathead gym. The sound system blares post-grunge rock. Muscleheads, most wearing Summer's Eve t-shirts, get their reps in with various free weights. It's their gym. Joe spots Bill on the bench press.
Push it out, bro! Breathe! Come on, strawberry shortcake!
Mike works out at the squat rack behind them, pumping out over 400 pounds. Bill struggles on his last rep, and Joe notices an Amazonian woman, Alicia, 30s, marching toward them. She's all business in her dark skirt suit. Joe helps Bill through the final push, and they ease the bar on the rack.
Good job, bro.
Bill sits up and catches his breath. He sees Alicia and rises.
Well, 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 what do we...
Alicia shoves him flat on the bench without breaking stride.
Sit your punk ass down.
Mike continues with his squatting. Undistracted, Alicia walks up to him.
We need to talk, boy.
I'll be with you in a minute, Alicia.
Alicia steps up and grabs the barbell. Mike, in full squat position, struggles against the added resistance, her big breasts almost smothering him.
No, T-Mobile. You're all out of minutes.
Mike groans in agony.
You're way behind schedule.
Well, we'll get you the lawns.
Damn straight you will. What's the holdup, anyway?
We're having some unexpected competition. Asswipe.
Alicia pushes down harder. Mike wails.
You just call me asswipe, boy?
No, no. This guy, we call him asswipe. Steve. He works for HEIKO!
Mike's about to pass out. Alicia heaves a barbell up and sets it on the rack. Mike falls over in exhaustion.
4th of July weekend. The rest of the lawns, or this goes out to your churchy client.
She whips out a magazine ad from the early 90s. Throb, Cape May's hottest dance club, with inset of a young G-string clad Mike dancing in a cage with a pacifier in his mouth. Mike grabs at it. Alicia swats his hand away.
Oh, come on! I was putting myself through VOTEC!
Tell that to the Board of Deacons. You won't need them after you win the combine anyway, but you don't want to sell your reputation, do you? Good. Get me them lines. We'll take care of the asswipe.
Alicia turns to walk away. Bill and Joe stand terrified. She glares at Joe and he backs off and trips over Bill. Exterior, Ocean City Boardwalk, Tilt-A-Whirl, night. An amusement park off the boardwalk of the resort town. Steve, Sonny, and Kyle have a ball in a whirling cart. They get out and Sonny slips a small bottle of Jack out of her purse and takes a swig. She offers some to Steve.
Do I have to call CPS on you?
He takes a swig.
Please, look around. It's standard issue to modern moms.
Steve looks around and sees different soccer moms sneaking shots out of their purses while their kids aren't looking. Maddie's puking over the railing. Tyler pokes at her with a toy sword. Sonny rushes toward them.
Shit. No trip to the boardwalk is complete without a kid vomiting.
Interior. Sonny's house. Kitchen. Night. Steve stands by the back door. Sonny enters the room.
Okay. They're in bed. Come on.
She takes Steve by the hand and leads him outside. Exterior, Sonny's house, backyard, night. Sunny and Steve step out onto the back deck. It's dark. Sunny flicks a switch and the backyard lights up.
Holy schnickies.
The backyard is adorned with raised vegetable gardens and flower beds with stone retaining walls, statues, bird baths, and all manner of potted fruit trees. Christmas lights wrap around the tree branches and line the retaining walls.
Pretty cool, huh?
Wow.
This is my proving ground. I've always wanted to do this for a living, but I guess I'll be doing life at Ronnie's.
She gestures to a pair of lawn chairs. They sit.
Is that so bad?
No, but I want to do more. Did you know people are actually ripping out their lawns and replacing them with plastic ones?
Yeah, I guess that's pretty weird.
Weird? It's just wrong.
He follows the trail of lights to a small pond with a water feature.
What's this?
Oh yeah, the pump broke last winter. I can't figure out what's wrong with it.
Steve takes another look around.
Well, if I were you, I'd quit that garden center and do this full time.
Get me some clients and maybe I will.
Maybe I will.
Really?
Sure. I made it work for HEIKO. All we need to do is put up a website, post your portfolio, and market the shit out of it.
You make it sound so easy.
It's what I do. But for asshole clients at big agencies, I could level down.
You do that for a little old asshole like me?
Sunny bats her eyelashes at him.
You look so effervescent right now.
They lean in close.
Mom! A spider!
Steve and Sunny snap out of it.
Shit.
Did you want me to go catch it?
Catch it? Oh no. He hacked into Minecraft. This might be a while.
Exterior marina restaurant. Deck bar. Day. Steve and the crew plow into drinks and bar food. HEIKO studies his notepad.
Yep. Just the parade route yards the day before, and we're all set for a 4th of July extravaganza at my place.
Sweet! Kegger!
I just love the 4th of July. I can smell it now. Barbecue ribs, collard greens with ham hock, cornbread, sweet potato pie.
Easy there, Song of the South.
Paul shows up and sets a fancy cocktail before Steve.
What's this?
From those swingers over there.
Steve looks behind him to a table. A sharp-dressed man, Tad Waters, late 40s, sits before a martini and plate of oysters, right off the set of Mad Men. His perky young colleague, Lisa, mid-20s, sits next to him, right out of the typing pool. Steve turns back around. The crew look at the table, then back to Steve.
Damn! What's that all about?
I don't know. Guess I should go over there, though.
Steve stands up and takes a sip of the cocktail.
Damn, that's a smart cocktail.
Exterior, marina restaurant, deck bar, Tad's table. Steve walks over to the table. Tad gets up from his oysters and smiles. Elisa smiles at him.
Hello?
Steve! Tad Waters.
They shake hands. Tad gestures for Steve to sit.
Please, have a seat. We've been looking forward to meeting you. This is Elisa, my SVP of marketing.
Hi, Elisa. Hello, Tad. Thanks for the drink.
You must be wondering why we called you over.
Am I in some sort of trouble?
No, not at all. You might know that I'm CEO of a modest holding company in Philadelphia. We own stock in and invest in mid-sized businesses, restaurants, real estate development, those sort of things.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
The work you've done rebranding your landscaping company really turned our heads.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah. What you did with that campaign was extraordinary. It was disruptive.
Yeah, disruptive.
Disruptive.
And you turned it around into a very profitable enterprise. Well, you tell them, Lisa.
Oh my God, like, I totally love how you took ownership of an integrated approach to reposition your company's value proposition that resonated in your vertical social sphere.
Mm-hmm.
I also like how you orchestrated a conversation around your target market pain points and integrated a cross-platform initiative that brought relevance to your back-end connection points.
Yeah, well...
And how you capitalized the convergence of target market buy-in in your user radius with maximizing the unified performance perspective as a natural extension was amazeballs.
Well, thank you.
Pretty good, huh? Wharton MBA.
Nice.
So tell me, what were the main drivers in your approach?
Well, essentially my strategy was to execute channel awareness into a sweet spot that shifted focus of consumption patterns and leveraged KPIs to deliver compelling results.
Wow.
And just like to design cool shit, I guess.
Of course. Steve, we're thinking we could use a man of your talents in our organization.
Oh?
We have a number of campaigns coming up, and we're batting around the idea of taking on an in-house creative director.
You don't say.
I sure do. Look, I'm having a little gathering on my boat on the 4th to watch the fireworks. Why don't you come by and we'll talk more?
Ted glances over his shoulder to his large yacht in the slip behind them. Steve is taken in by his majesty.
Well, yeah, that sounds great.
They all get up to shake hands.
Terrific. We'll see you then.
I look forward to sleeping with you. I mean, working with you.
Lisa giggles. Steve grins, turns around, and beams a bright smile. Exterior, nature park, day. A tranquil nature park with ponds and trees. Steve and Sunny walk along a boardwalk, tossing breadcrumbs to the ducks. Kyle pegs at them with pebbles.
Kyle, quit throwing stones at the ducks!
Steve stares ahead blankly, fiddling with a paper bag.
So I should be able to make it to Heiko's barbecue if I can get Debbie to wash the little bugger. Plus, she owes me for cleaning the puke off Maddie's Elsa Crocs.
That's cool.
Of course, if you want to go solo, I'd understand.
No, fine.
Steve tosses a piece of torn paper into the pond.
You're not upset about the other night, are you?
The other night? Oh, no, not at all. Sorry, I was just have a lot on my mind. I do have other plans for the fireworks, though.
Oh.
Steve sees her blank expression, stops and turns to her.
It's not a date or anything. A business prospect.
I wouldn't care either way. You ain't got no ring. You can do whatever.
Steve chuckles and spots a covered bridge across the pond.
I haven't been here since we raced each other on the roller coaster trails. Busted my lip on Heiko's banana seat coming off a jump.
They don't allow bikes back there anymore.
Yeah, and they make kids wear helmets these days. Not saying that's a bad thing, but everything's becoming so plastic around here.
He looks back at the playground. Sunny turns as well. They see a giant, garish play school plastic playground set upon the plot of Cyberlong artificial turf. Heiko's at his garage, night. The side door to the garage creaks open and the light of a flashlight spills in. A hand unscrews the gas tank of a lawnmower and pours sugar into it. Exterior, Rippy's house, front porch, day. It's the next day and Steve sits with Rippy on the front porch, sipping coffee from a large to-go cup. Steve looks at his wrist. He's not wearing a watch.
Where are those guys? I'm gonna start Miller time on early today.
A crusty old Camaro pulls up and parks on the street. Mungo steps out of the driver's side and sulks towards them.
Hey, what's going on? Where's the truck? Where's Heiko?
All the equipment's shot.
What do you mean?
Everything's busted. Lawnmowers, weed whackers, leaf blowers. The hedge trimmers won't even start.
You're shitting me.
Nah, dude.
Shit!
Balls! Shit balls!
You got... The guys stew for a minute.
Well, we gotta do something. Rippy, you have a weed whacker, don't you?
An old one. And it's out of string.
Go get it. Put some fishing line on it if you have to.
Okay.
Rippy dashes off.
Mungo, do you have a lawnmower?
My dad has one, but the blade hasn't been sharpened in years.
They'll have to do. We just have to give those lawns a good...
Steve holds out his hand. Rain drizzles from the sky and builds into a downpour.
Oh, come on.
Interior Rippy's house, basement, day. Typical teen raver setup. Lava lamps, Christmas lights along the molding, psychedelic posters, etc. A thumpy techno mix pumps out of the house speakers. Rippy sits at his desk toying with DJ software. Mungo slouches in a beanbag chair playing a wizardly fighting game on a console system. Steve stares out the window, fiddling with a Rubik's Cube. His feet tap to the beat of Rippy's music.
This is pretty burning, Rippy.
I spin mad wax, dog.
Steve sets the cube down and looks out the window.
Man, this sucks.
Yeah, those things are impossible, dude.
Mungo's character zaps a monster with a ball of light.
No, Dingbat. What are you gonna do about this rain?
Nothing we can do. It's over.
Rippy drops the bass.
Those lawns are as good as summer's eves.
Ugh, that slimy turd head.
What's the deal with you guys anyways? Why is he always calling you an asswipe?
Steve sighs and leans against the wall, staring off.
It was a long time ago. Junior year, winter break party at Melissa Romanelli's house.
Mungo sets his controller down.
Everyone was pretty tight, you know? Having a good time, the beer was flowing real good that night.
Rippy takes his eyes off his computer.
It was cold. So cold, I remember. Guys writing their names in the snow, on the back deck with their piss. I couldn't do it. I just couldn't do it.
Rippy's music fades out. Rain pelts the window.
So I went down the hallway. Her parents' bathroom. The door was cracked. I thought no one was in there, man. Why wasn't the door closed?
What was it? What did you see?
Yeah, brother, tell us. You're in a safe place.
I wasn't thinking. I just opened the door.
It's okay, man. Tell us.
It was Mike. Mike Summers. His backside facing the door. Facing me. Bent over.
You mean he was in white?
I saw it. I saw it, man, and I can never unsee it.
Rippy and Mungo scowl and grimace.
Oh, but why?
He turned around and saw me. Screamed at me to get out. I ran back through the party, right out the front door, and puked all over the driveway.
Yeah, but he was doing the wiping. Why are you...
He came out yelling, asswipe witness at me. That's what they called me for a month or so. It was kind of an awkward nickname, so eventually they just shortened it to asswipe.
So unfair, dude.
My high school experience sucked ever since then. Couldn't wait to graduate and get the hell out of here and never come back. Now look at me.
I'm sorry, bro.
Thanks for sharing.
The rain stops, but it's dusk out.
Hey, look.
But it's too late to do anything.
But yeah, we can't see in the dark, dude.
Steve looks around the room and surveys Rippy's raver gear, hula hoops, EL wire, glow sticks, etc. He sees a bag of glow-in-the-dark gravel. He darts his eyes across to the wall and sees a pair of night vision goggles hanging among some camping equipment.
Maybe we can.
Exterior, parade route lines, night. Steve marches down a lawn with headlamp on. He carries a large bag from which he disperses glow-in-the-dark sand. It lights up the patches of lawn it lands on. Rippy tears through patches of grass with his weed whacker and night vision goggles. Mungo pushes a mower over the luminescent patches of lawn. Steve smiles at the progress. The three gather at the middle of a lawn. Rippy and Mungo shut off their power tools.
Fellas, you should be very proud. We're the princes of the parade.
The boys do a fumbling three-way high five, all smiles. Exterior, parade route lawns, day. Steve stands with Sonny in the front of a crowd of parade watchers. Mungo and Rippy stand next to him, all looking dour. A marching band plays Stars and Stripes Forever. Steve looks over to see HEIKO getting a talking to by three of the customers with lawns on the parade route. Steve looks back to the parade. A float with the Linwood Girls Scout Troop number 609 cruises by. The girls throw candy towards the boys. Only Rippy scrambles to gather some up. The float cruises on, and there's a break in the parade, revealing the nightmarish lawn spectacle on the other side of the street. Discolored lawns with clumps of wet grass and deep tire marks filled with technicolored mud blemish the yards. The parade music continues. HEIKO walks up to Steve and scowls at him. He gestures to Mungo and Rippy to come along, and they follow. Steve makes a pleading gesture, but HEIKO storms off. Rippy and Mungo send apologetic looks to Steve, but follow HEIKO. Sonny gives Steve a sympathetic look and puts his hand in hers. Mrs. Russo walks up and tucks Steve's underwear into his back pocket, smiles, and saunters off. Sonny scowls at Steve and rips her hand out of his. She storms off. Steve watches her walk away as the marching band plays on. Heavy post-grunge music drowns out the band music. Raw eggs pelt and splatter all over Steve. He crouches and covers his head.
Asswipe!
After the barrage, Steve looks up to see the Summer's Eve landscaping float cruise off, the crew guffawing. Exterior, marina, dusk. Steve rolls up on three-speed, a little overdressed in dress jeans and a swanky patterned Goyabera. He locks the bike up against a dock post and walks toward the sound of a party. Exterior, Tad Waters' boat slip, night. Steve falls in line with party guests advancing up the stairs to the yacht. He approaches a muscle-bound bouncer, 30s, sitting with a clipboard.
Name?
Steve Connolly.
The bouncer peruses the list and shakes his head.
Don't see you on here.
What? No, Tad Waters invited me.
Can't let you in if you're not on the list.
Steve scopes the partiers on the deck and spots Alyssa with a glass of champagne.
Hey, Alyssa!
Alyssa glances at him, flashes a cursory smile, and glances off to be engaged by a group of other guests.
Can't let you in without the invitation.
No, I'm supposed to talk to him about a job.
Other guests are piling up behind him, hemming and hawing.
Please step aside, sir, so the invited guests can come in.
Steve sees Tad having a laugh with some other guests.
Wait, Tad! Tad!
Tad ignores him. Alicia appears and steps between the bouncer and Steve.
Position's been filled.
Huh?
I said, the position's been filled.
But we were going to leverage KPIs to maximum vertical consumption patterns?
Beat it, Pee-wee.
The guests in line laugh at his ridiculous encounter. Steve turns and lumbers back down the stairs, past amused entering guests. He reaches the bottom stair when...
S-Y!
Steve turns and looks up. Mike cackles at him. Fireworks pop above him. Steve casts pleading eyes to him. Tears welling. Mike leers at Steve, turns and rejoins the party. A group of yuppies, 20s to 30s, walk by him.
What's up, home slices?
They ignore him. Exterior, Sonny's house, backyard, night. Steve, muddy and sweaty in his dress clothes, fiddles with a water pump next to the pond. Electrical wire and tools scattered about him. The back screen door opens and Steve looks up. It's Deborah.
What the hell are you doing?
Steve places the pump into the pond and gathers his gear.
Just trying to fix something.
He nods to a light switch next to Deborah and walks off. Deborah flicks the switch. Water trickles over the water feature and the perimeter glows with soft underlaying. Exterior, suburban street, day. Steve rides his three-speed along and checks out the houses. Every other house has a cyber line. Exterior, Mr. Tucci's house, street, day. Steve rides up and sees both a Cyberlon truck and a Summer's Eve truck parked in the driveway. He screeches his bike to a stop, drops it, and marches to the backyard. Exterior, Mr. Tucci's house, backyard, day. Mike, Brian, and Mr. Tucci stand watching two workers, 30s, digging up the backyard.
I'm telling you, Mr. Tucci, this is the best investment you'll ever make.
Well, as long as I can work on my shark game in the winter, I'm a happy dago.
He looks up to see Steve enter the backyard.
Hey, what's this twink you doing here?
Mike and Brian look over to see Steve approaching them.
That's real dirty what you're doing, Summers.
Oh yeah? What's that?
Converting all our customers to Cyberlon?
They're not your customers anymore, loser. You got a problem with me helping the community save money on their water bills? You don't like us doing our part to save Spaceship Earth?
I don't like you doing your part to cheapen my hometown's aesthetic.
Oh yeah? What are you gonna do? Write a letter?
Brian and Mr. Tucci laugh. Steve stews.
Challenge me to a jet ski race? A surfing contest? How about a dance-off?
Mike starts a douchey club kid dance. His counterparts laugh again. Steve huffs.
Or do you want to fight? I'll beat you to the ground so bad, your buddies will have to dig you out with a backhoe.
Brian and Tucci double over. Steve takes a breath.
Oh, wait! I forgot. You don't have any buddies. Your crew deserted you. Heiko's nowhere to be seen. No one's on your side here, man. So why don't you just go jump in a lake?
Or better yet, a water hazard.
He and his interlocutors laugh. Steve reels from the verbal beatdown and turns to go.
Yeah, go mow your mom's lawn. Oh, wait. You can't. All your equipment's muffed up.
Steve pauses, then turns to Brian.
How would you know that, Brian?
You know, you guys suck. You're all so stupid. You probably broke your mowers and stuff.
Brian turns to Mike and Mr. Tucci, but they don't laugh.
I knew it. You dirtbags sabotaged our equipment. You broke into Hanko's garage and poured sugar in all our gas tanks.
No, I didn't. I have the key anyways, idiot. Shut up, Brian.
Ha-ha! And our zero turn. You were there at the driving range.
You rigged the governor. It all makes sense now.
Oh, like your glow-in-the-dark gravel trick. That made a lot of sense.
You're gonna pay. One way or another, you're gonna pay.
Whatever you say, asswipe.
All right, girls, I've had about enough of this. I'm sure you'll find some suitable way to settle this matter, but I have a 3 o'clock tee-off at the country club, and we still haven't completed our conversation, so take a hike, ass crack.
The three counterparts burst out laughing. Steve glares at Mike, then at Brian, and again at Mike and walks off. Steve mouths the words country club, and the light bulb goes off in his head. He cracks a smile and picks up the pace.
Yeah, you better run.
Exterior, Rippy's house, front yard, dusk. Rippy and Mungo kick around a hacky sack under the porch light. Steve rolls up the walkway on his three-speed. He dismounts and sets the kickstand.
Hey, guys, thanks for meeting me.
Sure.
The boys continue kicking the hacky sack, barely paying any attention to Steve. Steve sits down on the porch steps.
Any word from HEIKO?
Nope. I think he skipped town.
Jeez, we really screwed up, didn't we?
Rippy kicks the bag towards Steve. He whiffs it.
We? Come on, dude. That was all you the other night.
Steve picks up the bag and tosses it to Rippy, who kicks it about himself with ease.
You're right. I'm sorry I let you guys down.
We had to put in applications to Dino's.
Have you ever smelled someone coming off a 6-hour shift making Italian subs? That shit's putrid, man.
Rippy passes the bag to Mungo.
I know. Look, I need you guys.
What for?
Look around. Atlantic County's transforming into some giant, heinous, miniature golf course. And Mike Summers is behind it all.
What do you care?
Mungo kicks the footbag back at Rippy and pelts him in the chest. Rippy lets it sit there.
Yeah? What's the matter to you? You're just gonna go back to New York anyway. You'll forget all about it with your swanky party supermodels and WNBA stars.
Steve takes a deep breath.
None of that's true. There were no supermodels. I couldn't get laid out of a paper bag. Most of my nights out were spent getting kicked out of dive bars.
Rippy picks up the bag and fiddles with it.
And my job? I wasn't laid off. I was fired. That town chewed me up and spat me out.
Mungo and Rippy exchange a look.
But here, yeah, at first I felt like I came back with my tail between my legs. But you know what? I got my mojo back. I'm in the best shape of my life, and as bad as I've messed up, I feel for the first time in my life that what I'm doing is of real value.
Rippy and Mungo step closer to Steve.
Really, dude?
Yeah, man. Rebranding yard bodies beats anything I've ever done in New York.
Mungo and Rippy turn to each other.
They did turn things around.
But that's not the best part.
Really?
Steve nods.
What's the best part?
I get to hang out with you guys. It's like we're not even working. You make me feel so young again.
Rippy and Mungo exchange glances again.
Well, we like you too, dude.
You do?
Yeah, Steve. We love you.
You guys.
A tear wells in Steve's eye. He wipes it away. Rippy does the same, as does Mungo. They all sniff and wipe.
HEIKO and I go way back. He was the only kid who had my back growing up. He may never talk to me again, or even come back here after I ruined his business. But I have to do right by him.
How?
Steve pulls a folded up flyer out of his pocket. He hands it to Mungo. Mungo unfolds it. It's a flyer for the landscaping combine.
I signed us up.
You're bananas, dude.
Yeah, I mean, even if we could, all of our equipment is thrashed.
I know, but I have another plan.
Oh, boy.
What's that?
We unite the clans.
Exterior, suburban line, day. Steve, Rippy, and Mungo stand before burly, bearded Phil, 50s, owner of A1 Landscaping. He gasses up a hedge trimmer. His crew works in the background.
You mean to tell me that after taking 75% of our customers, then giving them over to Mike Summers, you punks want me to lend you my equipment to use in that stupid landscaping rodeo? I got that right?
Yeah, that was the idea.
Well, I got news for you. I'll be seeing you at the starting line.
Steve reaches in for a handshake.
Oh, well, in that case, best of luck.
Get out of here.
Exterior, suburban lawn 2, day. Steve and the boys stand before Ed. 40s, owner of Ed's Lawn Care, manning a leaf blower. His crew works around them, the loud machines drowning out their dialogue. Ed shakes his head. Steve reaches for a handshake. Ed swats the leaf blower at them. The boys take cover and run off. Exterior, suburban lawn 3, day. Steve and the boys stand before Sanchez, 50s, owner of the Paisaísimo del Sanchez. His crew works in the background. He rattles on in animated, unintelligible Spanish, his head about to explode. Steve looks to Rippy, who shakes his head, then to Mungo, who shrugs. Steve nods and reaches out to shake Sanchez's hand. He swats it away and kicks at Steve. They all dash off. Exterior, suburban lawn 4, day. Steve and the boys stand with androgynous Gene, 50s, owner of Green Jeans Vegan Lawn Care. The electric-powered mowers and trimmers of his crew whirr in the background.
What you did to us is very hurtful. I'm still processing, so I'm afraid I'm unable to hold space for this conversation. I need you to respect that, okay?
Yes, of course. Thanks anyway, man.
I'm a woman.
Oh.
Get out of my personal space.
Steve and the boys fly back.
Oh, sorry.
Lay off the gluten, dude.
Gene storms off in the other direction. Exterior, sidewalk, day. Steve and the boys dawdle along.
Damn it. That was the last of everyone who's still in business around here. And the combine starts in a little over an hour.
Beat scene, man.
A truck horn honks from across the street. The boys look over and Sonny sits in an idling Ronnie's Garden Center pickup truck with an attached trailer loaded with shiny new landscaping gear.
Sonny?
Steve beams a smile at her, but she's all business.
Rippy, you can ride with me.
Exterior, country club, television broadcast, day. An aerial view of crowds gathered on the fairways of a golf course. Dramatic sports music plays as overproduced digital graphics sweep into frame, revealing the title card. Fifth annual Home Depot South Jersey Regional Landscaping Combine.
Coming to you live from Seaview Country Club. In beautiful southern New Jersey, it's the fifth annual Home Depot South Jersey Regional Landscaping Combine.
Exterior, sportscaster stage, continuous. Two sportscasters sit behind a desk facing the camera. On the left sits our announcer, Frank, 50s, a hefty but buttoned-up showbiz type. On the right, Jim, 50s, a swarthy, ropey working man.
Good afternoon, folks. I'm Frank Westerly. With me today is Jim Doherty, veteran South Jersey landscaper and two-time winner of this competition. Jim, what are your thoughts on this exciting event today?
A monitor to the side displays contestants stretching, warming up, etc.
Frank, I couldn't be more excited. We have South Jersey's absolute finest in the art of landscape maintenance here today.
Expect to be mowed over by the amazing skills of these talented men and women. The team to really look out for is the Summer's Eve Landscaping Crew.
The monitor displays Mike and crew rallying, then footage of a previous year's event with Mike finishing a race and racing his weed whacker.
They're fierce competitors, which comes at no surprise since they're defending champions 3 years running. The other teams all have a tough day ahead of them going up against this outfit.
The monitor cuts to other contestants warming up.
And adding some more heat to the competition, this year the winners will be awarded a contract with the Atlantic County worth a whopping $500,000.
Jim shoots a look at Frank.
Huh?
You heard that right, folks. We're talking all county-owned properties and facilities. Public parks, schools, courthouses, insane asylums, the whole bit.
But all we ever got were gift certificates to Home Depot.
Exterior, under bleachers, day. Under the roaring crowd and unintelligible announcements sounding over the PA system, Mungo ties a black headband upon his head. Steve tightens his bootlace with a double knot. Ribby slips black work gloves over his tiny wrists. The boys form a huddle.
All right, guys. Whatever happens, just leave here today knowing in our hearts we... What is it, Ribby?
I got a pee-pee.
Oh, man.
It's my nerves! Sorry.
Yeah, me too. I think I drank too much Gatorade.
All right, Ribby, you're up first, so hurry back. Ready?
Steve reaches his right hand in. Rippy and Mungo do the same and stack hands upon Steve.
Break!
They pump their stacked hands and dissolve the huddle. Exterior, under bleachers, 200 yards away, day. Down a ways, Mike and his team stretch and warm up. Mike wraps his wrists with tape. Joe sees Steve down the way.
Look, your boyfriend's here.
Mike looks over and huffs. He flicks Joe in the nuts.
Listen up, boys. Those Sallys are not a threat to us, but make damn sure they don't win any points today. Got it?
Got it. Exterior, under bleachers, Steve's prep area, day. Steve adjusts his web belt. Sunny appears.
Hey.
Steve looks up.
Hey, look, I...
Really? I don't want to hear it.
But...
Good luck out there today, okay?
Thanks.
See? Sunny turns to leave, then stops.
And thanks for fixing my pond. It's dope.
She turns away and walks off. Steve sulks.
Yeah, it's pretty tight.
Exterior, sportscaster stage, day. Frank and Jim are back on the air after a commercial break. Jim sulks in his seat with arms folded.
Welcome back, folks. We're setting up for our first event, the String Trimmer Edging Dash. Jim, what do we need to know about this event?
Well, Frank, you gotta be able to go fast in a straight line and backwards.
Thanks. Now, let's go to the field for the first heat of edging action.
Exterior, edging contest field, day. Contestants line up before long sections of temporary sidewalk. They power up their weed whackers and get last-minute coaching by their teammates. A referee, 60s, inspects the marks of each contestant. Steve and Mungo stand with Rippy as he pull-starts his trimmer.
Okay, now take it easy on this one. We don't want you to blow your wad here.
Well, I already blew chunks.
Steve slides protective glasses over Rippy's eyes.
You'll be all right. Now go get him, kid.
The referee steps into view of all contestants.
Edgers, now remember that every inch you stray from the sidewalk will result in a 1 second penalty. Got that?
The contestants all face the referee and nod.
Up and back to the line finishes the race. Edgers, on your marks.
The contestants ready themselves at their marks. Weed whackers revving.
Set.
Rippy takes a deep breath. Sweat streams down his brow. Joe sneers at Rippy from the lane to his right. Sanchez sneers at him from his left. Rippy gulps. The referee raises his starter pistol. Bang!
Go!
Rippy and the other contestants all dash off backwards.
Go, Rippy!
Full speed behind, dude!
Rippy has a good lead on everyone. He reaches the end, turns around, and starts down the other side. Sanchez is right behind him, followed by Joe.
Looks like a dark horse from the Yard Bodies team taking a surprise lead.
That's some good form there, Frank.
But Sanchez is not far behind. If Yard Bodies lose steam here, it's his race. They're neck and neck.
Rippy puts everything into it. Sanchez struggles to keep up. Joe holds steady in third. They near the finish line. Sanchez sweeps his trimmer at Rippy's feet. Rippy loses his balance, yet keeps his trimmer in control. He stumbles across the finish line. Joe takes first place, and the Summer's Eve cruise celebrates.
Oh, come on. That was dirty, Sanchez.
Exterior, sportscaster stage, continuous.
Wow. Things are really heating up with an unexpected placing by Rippy Gallagher of the Yard Bodies Lawn Care team. But it looks like the other teams don't want them anywhere near the scoreboard.
Can't say I blame them, considering Yard Bodies caused folks to convert to that ridiculous plastic grass. Atlantic County is going down the toilet.
Jim, please. Cyberlawn is a sponsor.
Jim reaches for his crotch under the desk.
Sponsor this.
Exterior, push mower field, day. Contestants work in sections using push mowers.
In our next event, competitors race to complete a 400 square yard plot of lawn.
Steve steadies his mower forward. He empties his bag into a trash can, reattaches it to the mower, and pushes on.
And their lines need to be clean with no stray grass clippings.
In the grandstand.
There you go, kid.
And with that, we'll introduce our panel of judges.
Exterior, grandstand, continuous. A row of judges sit at a long table on the top level of the bleacher. Our announcer introduces them. George Gunderson, 60s, grins left and right to the crowd.
First, we have our chief judge, George Gunderson, chairman of the CU Country Club.
Iris Schulman, 60s, watches the action with binoculars.
Next, we have Iris Schulman, president of the Atlantic County Beautification Committee.
Thornton Phillips, 50s, studies the action.
Thornton Phillips, head of the Horticulture Department at Stockton University.
Jody Rizzo, 40s, chews gum and sets her cell phone down.
Jody Rizzo, editor-in-chief of Atlantic City Homes and Gardens magazine.
Tad does elbow-elbow, wrist-wrist to the crowd.
And finally, Tad Waters, a prominent Philadelphia businessman with many fingers in many pies.
Tad gives a thumbs up and claps his hands. Exterior, push mower field, continuous. Steve hears this and scowls at the grandstand.
What?
Mungo and Rippy look up as well. Steve approaches them, about to make a turn for his next swab.
Son of a bitch! Wait, who's that?
Don't worry about him. Just keep your eye on the focal point, like I taught you, dude.
All right. Watch my six.
Steve pushes forward. Bill pulls up next to him, releases his deflector shield, and spring clumps at the Steve swath.
Nerd buddies!
Bill snickers and pushes on. Steve looks behind him.
Oh, you guys! My six! My six!
Exterior, leaf blower lot, day. Contestants blow piles of grass clippings and leaves with leaf blowers and corral them into the adjacent lawn. Joe blows clippings back onto Mungo's work area. Mungo looks toward the ref, whose back is turned.
Oh, come on, dude. Yard body's catching wind from Summer's Eve and the leaf blower roundup. Once again, the refs don't seem to notice.
Get out your tinfoil hats, folks.
Joe finishes clearing his area and raises his arms in triumph. His crew join in hooting and hollering. Mungo finishes his area and casts a dejected look. Exterior, mulching lot, day. Contestants scurry with wheelbarrows between large piles of mulch and prop flower beds. Steve shovels mulch from a large pile into a wheelbarrow.
Yard body's going hard at the mulching two-yard scramble.
Mike runs by and kicks his wheelbarrow over. Exterior, lawn pattern field, day. Contestants ride zero turns and stand-on mowers, each making complex patterns. Mungo focuses his ride on a point down the line.
Our competitors exercise creative latitude to come up with complex designs here in the lawn pattern freestyle.
Yep, you can't do that on no counterfeit grass.
Mike nods to Bill, who's holding a bulky sack. He strolls toward Mungo's area and sets the sack down. Four kittens scurry out onto the field.
Uh-oh, looks like we have some unexpected visitors.
Mungo, watch out!
Mungo swerves and weaves on his stand-on.
Well, that's not good for the yard body's design. He can always go back and fix it, but it will cost him time. But wait.
The judges nod at Mungo's design. An intricate pattern of swervy cross-hatch swaths. Tad looks upset.
Yard body's making lemonade out of lemons, but barely inching closer to Summer's Eve's lead.
Mungo caresses a kitten and hands it to the little girl, seven. Steve and Rippy hand the other kittens to other kids, six to eight. Exterior, grandstand, day. Tad, with back to the table, clutches his cell phone close.
Take them out, dammit.
Exterior, hedgerow, day. Contestants each work on a section of tall hedging along a fairway with ladders and power hedgers. Rippy stands atop his ladder and sweeps at the hedge with his electric trimmers.
Go!
Rippy Gallagher, the veritable workhorse of the yard bodies.
Brian struggles with his oversized hedge trimmer. He looks down and sees a power cord leading back to Rippy's ladder.
I personally would have gone with the gas power articulated 24 instead of that electric 17 he's using. But the kid's pretty shrimpy.
Brian looks over to Mike. Mike nods.
Well, I'd say it's a good strategy on his part. A lightweight trimmer lets a guy like him scurry up and down that ladder like a spider on a window screen.
Brian climbs down the ladder and loops the cord under his boot. He nudges his ladder forward and kicks the cord. Rippy reaches for a final patch, but the ladder yanks from under him. His trimmer flies off.
Ah!
Rippy crashes down into the grass. Steve and Mungo dash toward him, kneel beside him, and give support.
Rippy,
you all right, dude?
My ankle! I think I destroyed it!
Ah, damn it! Those damn assholes!
The Summer's Eve crew all guffaw. Steve faces them about to charge. Mungo grabs him.
Save it, dude. There's one more event left, and you're it.
The lawn feature medley? But Ribby's our best guy on Weed Whacker.
You're the best guy now, Steven. Remember the cemetery. Channel that anger.
Okay, Rippy. I will. This one's for you, pal.
Exterior, obstacle course, day. A large field section to contain several identical features, flower beds, bird baths, wading pools, etc.
They saved the best event for last here, folks. The lawn feature medley consists of a two-man team. First a precise trimming around various features, and then he tag-teams his partner, who finishes the job with a zero turn.
Sounds like a good time to me, Frank.
Steve warms up at the starting line. Rippy, in crutches, psychs him up. Mungo stands by on his stand-on mower. The other contestants get pepped up by their own teammates. Mike warms up at his line next to Steve. The summer's eve crew sneer at Steve and his boys.
Why don't you just go away and have a soy latte, asswipe?
Steve ignores him and faces the course. He starts up his trimmer. The referee steps out into the open.
Okay, this is the last event. Let's keep it clean, boys.
Mike smirks and motions to Phil, who shifts his position. Steve watches Phil's move. He looks to Mungo, who shrugs.
Looks like Summer's Eve and A1 are switching up their strategies by taking the course in reverse.
The cut above guy, Tom, 40s, shifts his position away from Mike, as does Ed, who moves closer to Phil. Steve looks around him, shifting focus to each of the men. They all eye him with bloodlust. Steve looks to Rippy. Rippy gulps.
Trimmers, on your marks.
Steve takes a deep breath and clenches his jaw.
Set.
Mike snarls at Steve. The referee raises his starter pistol. Bang! Steve dashes off, sweeping his trimmer around a birdbath. The other contestants do the same and make their way along flower beds, around birdbaths, across sections of temporary sidewalk, etc.
And they're off! Things are looking neck and neck so far. No discernible leader here.
Phil starts around his flower bed, speeds up, and body checks Steve, who crashes into the birdbath.
WTF, man!
Ouch! Well, that was a very unorthodox move by A1. No doubt there will be repercussions.
The referee approaches Phil.
You're out!
Yeah.
Phil shuts off his trimmer and makes his way off the field. Steve sets the birdbath back and continues trimming. Phil looks up in the grandstands and makes a money-counting hand gesture. Tad smiles and nods. Rippy watches Tad's interaction with Phil and turns towards Steve.
Steve, watch your six. They got all the other teams after you.
Shit. Steve dashes up to a cluster of garden gnomes and sweeps away at the grass between them.
Look out!
Ed charges at Steve with his weed whacker. Steve ducks and continues his work.
What are you doing, man?
Staying in business.
Steve jabs his weed whacker into a patch of gravel, kicking up a cloud of dust. The cloud dissipates and Steve is gone. Ed stands bemused. The referee marches up to Ed.
You're out.
Ed snickers and walks off and looks to Tad, who makes a money fanning gesture. Phil sees this.
Hey, that's my cut.
He charges at Ed and they get into a scuffle. They wrestle into the play area of the sharpest cut guy.
Hey, get out of here!
He punches out Phil and the bench is clear. Steve dashes to the garden pond and sweeps at the grass along it. Tom charges at Steve.
Aw, come on, you two?
Who's the sexy guy now?
Tom charges at Steve, who evades him while trimming the outline of the pond.
Quit it, man! If I lose, we all lose!
You're already a loser.
Tom closes in on Steve and swings his weed whacker at him. Steve squeals as the neck strikes his gut, but he clenches the tool and sends Tom sailing into the pond. The referee comes up to the edge of the pond.
You're out!
No, you're out!
Tom tugs the referee by the shirt into the pond. Steve dashes along the final flower bed.
Absolute pandemonium here at the Seaview Country Club, folks. Yard bodies holding steady with just their last flower bed, and...
He turns the corner and Mike Summers awaits him.
Get out of my way, Summers.
You need to quit showing up where you're not wanted.
You could have just locked the door.
You got off on it.
Steve charges at Mike with his weed whacker. Whistles from the referee's blare. Mike swats at Steve. Their weed whackers clang together like Darth Vader and Obi-Wan Kenobi. The other contestants are squared off in fights of their own. Absolute chaos on the country club grounds. Steve and Mike take turns swinging at each other with the awkward heavy power tools, each parrying each other's blows. Mike swats at Steve and swishes by his shoulder. A speck of blood peeks through a tiny gash in his shirt.
Ah!
Rippy and Mungo react.
Oh! Medic!
Steve retreats to catch his breath and check the wound. It's nothing big, but he still breathes heavy. Mike, in much better shape, is barely winded.
Give it up, asswipe.
No way! Come on, let's dance!
Steve mocks the dance move Mike performed the day before. Mike charges. Steve fakes a lunge and Mike swings at him. He clutches the tool's neck and knees Mike in the gut. Mike keels over and drops his weed whacker. Bill sets his stand-on mower to full throttle and takes off. Mungo sees this and launches in pursuit on his own stand-on. Steve steps on Mike's throat and raises his weed whacker with the trimmer head aimed at Mike's face.
What's my name?
Asswipe.
Joe turns to Brian.
Get him!
Joe and Brian dash towards Steve.
Oh, it's on now.
Rippy is now in their path. He whips his crutch from under his arm and trips Brian with it. Brian sails into a table of Gatorade. Cups and coolers splash all over him.
Take a bath, Brian. You're grimy.
Steve presses his foot further into Mike's throat and moves the trimmer head closer.
What is my name?
Mike groans and squirms but can't break free.
Steve.
Steve cracks a smile and begins to stand down. Mungo slams into Bill's mower, sending him flying. He stumbles onto Joe, and they both crash into Steve. Steve falls forward, and the trimmer head flies straight at Mike's face. Exterior, award stage, day. A grand stage with podiums set up in the middle of a putting green. The judges stand to one side, and the teams cluster on the other side. A large audience faces the stage. Mike stands scowling with his team, dirty and sweaty, with half his hair now buzzed off. A beefed-up Skrillex. Steve stands with Rippy and Mungo, sweaty and exhausted.
Well, all I can say, Jim, is this was quite an exciting day of landscaping.
That was completely messed up.
The scores have all been tallied, and the winners will now be presented by Atlantic County Executive Denny Livingston.
Tall, balding Denny Livingston, 60s, steps to the podium.
Ladies and gentlemen, first off, I wish to express my deepest disgust to all the men and women who competed here today. Your displays of strength, skill, and sportsmanship were deplorable.
Steve furrows his brow. He looks around and sees most of the other contestants looking anxious.
At this time, we present the winners of today's events. And before I do, please know that, in my heart, you're all derelicts.
Steve takes hold of Rippy's hand with his left and Mungo's with his right. Mungo looks up to Steve and ekes a smile.
Our first place finishers and recipients of the $500,000 landscaping contract with the county goes to...
Steve and the boys watch intently.
Paisajimo del Sanchez!
Steve and the boys all drop their heads. The Mexican crew all celebrate. A mariachi band joins in playing the Mexican hat dance. The Summer's Eve crew throw a fit.
That's bullshit, man!
Well, that comes as no surprise there, Jim.
Yep. It just goes to show, when it comes to landscaping, nobody beats the Mexicans.
Tack clears his throat and approaches the podium. He hands a paper to an official, 50s. The official reads it, walks up to Denny and whispers in his ear. His eyes widen.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's been an issue in the judging. Sanchez Landscaping is disqualified on account of undocumented workers on their crew.
The mariachi music fizzles and their crew stops cheering.
That means... the winner will now go to the second place finishers.
Steve and the boys look up.
Summer's Eve Landscaping.
The Summer's Eve crew hoot and holler. Steve and the boys drop their heads once again. Mike and his crew rush up to the stage, greeted by Tad.
Well, that's quite a twist, but no surprise given the raw power of the Summer's Eve.
Hold on.
Everyone turns to see Heiko stumbling through the crowd with a squirrely working man type, Jerry, 40s in tow.
Heiko?
Heiko?
They take the stage and approach Denny. Jerry hiccups.
You friggin' kidding me? Get lost, Heiko! Who's this lush?
Tad locks eyes with Jerry and quickly looks away.
You can't give them the contract.
Who are you? Extinguish that cigarette.
Heiko shoves the smoke in his pocket and pats it out.
Tell them, Jerry.
Jerry takes the microphone.
I had a landscaping business up in Ocean County. That is, until I met him.
He points at Tad. Tad looks around nervously.
What? Everyone knows me. I'm a likable guy. I thought so too. He gave me and some other businesses a shit ton of money to turn our customers over to his company, Cyberlawn.
The crowd collectively murmurs. Steve scowls at Ted.
You greasy prick. There never was any job.
Go on.
Fake grass all over the place caused home values to tank. Then his investors came in and bought them all for cheap.
Yes, I heard about this. An absolute travesty.
I'll say, he got the county to rezone those properties and knock them down to build condos.
The crowd burbles, uncertain and confused.
Now I live in a shack in the Pine Barrens.
He's gonna turn our beach community into vacation homes for rich suies.
We'll all have to move to the Pine Barrens.
The crowd resumes burbling. Steve turns to Denny.
Can I say something?
Denny gently directs him to the microphone.
You know, I haven't been around a while, but
This is my childhood home.
The judges all nod along sagely. Mrs. Russo watches adoringly, as do Connie and Linda.
I grew up here. I care about the backyards I grew up playing in. And I care about where my friends' kids are playing, and where their kids will play too.
Sunny is transfixed. Deborah stands next to her with her RBF. Their kids look bored. Maddie picks her nose.
Sure, we were in a drought, but we got through it. Are we really going to let a scheming businessman come here at the first sign of trouble and turn our town into some giant Lego playset for his own profit?
The crowd groans. Dr. Slattery and Mrs. Gunther nod along.
If and when I go back to the city, I want to know that I can come back here and go to the park and lay in the grass or play touch football with my friends in their backyards and get grass stains on my pants and dirt under my fingernails.
The crowd coos. Bartender Paul listens with his son, Ten.
I may not be the best guy to mow your lawns. Hell, I'm not allowed within 100 yards of most of them, but I do care about our community's natural beauty. Mike Summers doesn't, and Cyberlawn sure as hell doesn't either.
The crowd collectively cheers and shouts expletives at Tad and Mike, etc. Carl claps from the stands.
Hey, come on! It's just business.
Yeah, and who cares? We won fair and square. Now where's that big cardboard check at? Oh, I'm ready for my photo.
They sabotaged our equipment, dude.
Is this true?
Hell no. You can't prove anything anyway.
Steve and Heiko exchange baffled looks.
Well, I'm afraid he's right, gentlemen. It's no bearing on the contest. Margaret, bring up the checks.
The crowd groans. Mike and his crew all snicker. Denny's secretary, Margaret, 50s, clambers up the stairs with an oversized check, followed by a photographer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now present our winners.
The official steps up to Denny and whispers into his ear. His eyes light up and he smiles.
Yard Bodies Lawn Care!
What?
The crowd erupts in cheering and applause. Steve and the boys roar in triumph. They hug and rush up the stage and hug with Heiko. Celebratory dance music kicks in. The photographer snaps photos of the crew. Margaret dons them with medals and gives Mungo an especially long hug and kiss on the cheek.
Thanks, Mom.
Alicia looks disgusted as she watches Mrs. Wolf do an 80s dance. Mike and Tad charge up to Denny.
What the hell, Denny?
Yeah, will you pull it, yo?
I'm afraid you've also been disqualified.
What?
It appears your whole team tested positive for performance-enhancing drugs. You should all be ashamed.
The official points out JD in the stands to Denny. JD raises a mason jar full of pee and gives a thumbs up.
How'd you get that?
That's enough out of you.
Mrs. Gunther grabs a tomato out of her bag and tosses it at Mike. It plops on the stage and rolls to his foot.
Mrs. Gunther? But I planted that little baby. I fertilized him.
Other audience members grab tomatoes and peg them at Mike, Tad, and the Summer's Eve crew.
Ah!
The men all duck for cover as they get pelted by to the tomatoes. Steve and the crew scramble off the stage. Exterior, obstacle course pond, day. Steve and Heiko find a quiet moment together in front of the fountain. Rippy and Mungo talk with Jerry in the background.
Hey, good thing you went on that field trip.
It was a good bender until I ran into Cherry. Otherwise, I was about to drink myself to death.
Wow, that would have sucked.
Yeah, thanks for not giving up on me. We cool?
We cool.
They give each other a big bro hug. Sunny appears.
Hey, butt spray.
Steve is taken aback.
Hey, butt spray.
Mrs. Russo told me you went to the bathroom in your pants.
Yeah, well...
It happens to the best of us.
Steve sighs and smiles.
So, does this mean you'll be sticking around and working for Heiko?
No, not exactly.
Oh.
But I'm not going anywhere. If you don't mind being friends with a grasshole.
Sunny smiles.
Sure. But nothing penetrating or anything, right?
Steve lets his smile fade.
Oh, right.
But how about a kiss?
Steve grins and steps closer.
That resonates.
Steve takes her hand and draws her toward him. He's about to kiss her, but his phone rings. He pauses and looks at it.
Recruiter.
Oh, you should take it.
Steve looks at her, to the phone, back to her. He tosses the phone into the pond. She jumps into his arms and they kiss. The crowd cheers. Rippy and Mungo dance around like monkeys. Heiko launches into a spastic mime of jerking off.
Oh my god, it's so hot.
Steve keeps the kiss going and shoves Heiko into the pond with his foot. Paul watches from the crowd. He's talking to a guy, 40s, next to him.
Yeah, we had a problem with a cod reader a couple months ago. I told him his cod was declined.
Whoops.
Heiko emerges, rubbing his throat and spits water out as if he were a giant ejaculating penis. The crowd dissipates. Sunny and Steve release their kiss.
But if you're not going to work for Heiko anymore, and you're not going back to New York...
I have something else in mind.
Exterior, courthouse grounds, day. Landscapers in yard bodies uniforms are hard at work mowing the grass, trimming hedges, weed whacking, etc. Rippy, now a crew chief, marches through the grounds carrying a clipboard. He turns behind him.
Hurry up with that mulch, slacker!
Behind him, Brian struggles with a wheelbarrow full of mulch.
Yeah.
Mungo sweeps by on a stand-on, nearly knocking him over. Rippy passes by two of Sanchez's former workers on ladders trimming hedges.
Buenos dias, you guys!
The two men turn from their work and salute to Rippy. Across the lawn, Heiko stands with Denny, pointing to the work being done. Denny nods in approval. Steve and Sonny walk up with an iPad and matching polo shirts with S&S designs embroidered on them. Steve's wearing designer frames again. Sonny shows Denny a graphic mock-up of a flower bed arrangement on an iPad and points to a plot where workers plant shrubs and flowers, realizing their design. Denny nods in agreement, then shakes Sonny, Steve, and Heiko's hands. Sonny hugs Heiko. Steve shakes his head.
Partner.
Partners.
Ready?
Sonny nods and slides her sunglasses on.
Let's roll, son.
Steve leads her to a riding mower. He hops on and she climbs on behind him. They ride off into the sunset, chased by the yapping dog thought to have been run over earlier. The end.